नमस्ते, आई जी विन डॉक्टर शर्मा कादरी फ्रॉम फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट फ्रैक्चर बेसिक्स ऑफ फ्रैक्चर फ्रैक्चर हीलिंग एंड कॉम्प्लिकेशंस ऑफ फ्रैक्चर सो लेट्स स्टार्ट व्हाट इज अ फ्रैक्चर अ फ्रैक्चर इज अ ब्रेकडाउन इन द कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ द बोन Or a fracture is a broken bone. It can range from a thin crack to a complete break. Bone can fracture crosswise, lengthwise, or several places. Most fracture happens when the bone is impacted by more force or pressure than it can support. What are the symptoms of the fracture? Symptoms are as follows. They become worse when the patient moves or touches the injured area, or in some cases, patient may even pass out from the pain. Patient may feel dizzy or chilled from shock. The other symptoms are a snap or grinding sound when the injury occurs, swelling, redness, and bruising in the injured area, difficulty supporting weight with the injured area, visible deformity in the injured area. Different types of fractures are the fracture is depend on different bases. Like if we are talk about on the basis of the etiology, there are two types of the fracture. One first is traumatic and the another one is pathological. The traumatic fracture may occur due to any trauma and pathological fracture may occur due to any pathology, example osteoporosis. The other type of fracture is on the basis of the external environment. So if the fracture is involved externally or the bone affected part is imposed with the environment, it is kind of external fracture. And whereas the internal fracture, when the bone or impacted part may not come with the external environment. The other kind of fracture is on the basis of displacement. So there is two type of the displacement fracture. One is displaced and another one is undisplaced. As the name indicates, undisplaced means the bone may do not displace from the site, but in displaced fracture, bone may shifted or may angulated or may rotate. It is like if this is the bone and the fracture occurs between here, then in shifting, the bone may shift like this and there is angulation, the bone may create angulation like this. And if there is rotation, the bone may rotate like this. The another type of the fracture is on the basis of the pattern, where there is a transverse fracture, where fractures occur transversely, oblique fracture, where fractures occur obliquely, segmental fracture, where bone is fractured in 1, 2, 3 parts, comminuted fracture, where the bone is fractured in many parts. Another one is the green stick fracture, where it may be complete or incomplete. You can see that one side of the bone is attached and another one is detached. If we talk about the causes or indications of the fracture, so fracture may develop when the bone is impacted with greater pressure or force than in support. The force usually occurs suddenly or in very intense. The strength of the force determines the severity of the fracture. Some common fractures include fall, direct strike to the body, traumatic events such as car accident or gunshot wound, injuries from sports. Now, if we talk about the complications of fractures are general and local. Then the local are also divided in early and late complications. General complications are shock, hypovolemic or hemorrhagic shock, septic shock, neurological shock, fat embolism, pulmonary embolism, Crush syndrome, multiple organ failure syndrome, thromboembolism, tetanus, gas gangrene. The local complications are early visceral injuries, the lung, the bladder, the urethra, and the rectum, vascular injuries, nerve injuries, compartment syndrome, hemostasis, infection, gas gangrene, fracture blisters, plaster, and pressure sores. The late complications are delayed union, non-union, mass union, avascular necrosis, growth disturbance, bad shore, myositis ossification, muscle contracture, tendon lesions, nerve compression and entrapment, joint instability, joint stiffness, complex regional pain syndrome, osteoarthritis. Early complications are local visceral injuries, vascular injuries, nerve injuries, compartment syndrome, hemostasis, infection, gas gangrene. Local visceral injuries. Fracture around the trunk are often caused by injury of the adjacent viscera. Pelvic fracture, bladder and urethral rupture, rib fracture, penetration to the lung, pneumothorax, vascular injuries, most commonly knee, femoral shaft, elbow and humerus. Artery may be cut, torn, compressed or enema may be detached. Thrombus block, artery spasm, the effect is decreased blood pressure flow because ischemia leads to tissue death and peripheral gangrene. Common vascular injuries may associated with following fracture. First rib or clavicle fracture, shoulder dislocation, axillary artery, first rib or clavicle fracture, subclavian artery, humeral supracondylar fracture, brachial artery, elbow dislocation, brachial artery, pelvic fracture, internal iliac, femoral supracondylar fracture, femoral artery, knee dislocation, popliteal artery, proximal tibia, popliteal and its branches. General fractures, patients with ischemia may have paresthesia. That means the patient with ischemia may have 5P symptoms, which are paresthesia or numbness, pain, pallor, pulselessness, paralysis. Investigate if suspect vascular injury, angiogram. The treatment is emergency treatment, all bandages, splint removed, the fracture x-ray again, circulation reassessed for next half hour. If no improvement, do vessels exploration, suture torn vessels, vein grafting. If thrombus, do endarterectomy. Aim to restore blood flow. The nerve injury, variable degree of motor and second sensory loss along the distribution of the nerve. Maybe neuropraxia, axonotomies, ptomesis, or neurotomesis. Radial nerve is most frequently damaged nerve. So, if we talk about the different nerve and where the trauma of this nerve occurs and what is the effect the patient faces, let's discuss the common nerve. The first one is axillary. Trauma is dislocation of shoulder. Effect, deltoid paralysis. Radial, fracture of humerus, wrist drop. Median, supracondylar fracture of humerus, pointing index. Ulnar, median epicondylar fracture, humerus, claw hand. Sciatic, post dislocation of hip, foot drop. Comal peroneal, knee dislocation, foot drop. In close injury, nerve is seldom served and spontaneous recovery should be awaited. In open fracture, complete lesion, neurotomesis, the nerve is explored during wound and repaired. Compartment syndrome. Compartment syndrome involves the compression of nerve and blood vessels within an enclosed space, leading to impaired blood flow and nerve damage. Fascia separate group of muscles in the arm and legs from each other. Inside each layer of fascia is confined space called a compartment that includes the muscle tissue, nerve, bone, and blood vessels. A rise in pressure within these compartments may jeopardize the blood supply to the muscles and nerve within the compartment. Causes are any injury, infection leading to edema of muscle, fracture hematoma within the compartment, ischemia of the compartment leading to muscle, edema due to tight bandage or cast. Hallmark system symptoms, severe pain that does not respond to elevation or pain medication. In more advanced case, there may be decreased sensation, weakness, and painless of the skin. Injury with a high risk of developing compartment syndrome, fracture of elbow, fracture of forearm, or fracture of proximal third of the tibia. If we talk about Foxman ischemia, there is a cycle where arterial damage occurs, then blood flow decreases and ischemia occurs. 5PV phase, which is pain, pallor, paresthesia, pulselessness, and paralysis. Compartment syndrome may occur, ischemia may lead edema, and may show with the direct injury. Now, if we talk about the treatment, first remove all the bandages and dressing. Fasciotomy is performed. The wound should not be left open, the infected 2 days later. If there is muscle necrosis, debridement. If muscle is healthy, suture, grafted. Infection, causes open fracture, use of operative method in is fracture when becomes inflamed and start draining fluids. Infection may be superficial, moderate, severe. Severe may indicate gangrene, moderate osteomyelitis. Post-traumatic fracture is most common cause of the chronic osteomyelitis. Union will be show an increased chance of refracting. Gas gangrene produce an anaerobic. These organs can survive in decreased O2 tension. Toxins produce will destroy and cell wall and leads to tissue necrosis. Clinical features: within 24 hours, patient complain intense pain, swelling around the bone, brownish discharge, gas formation, pyrexia, characteristic swelling, increased pulse rate, toxemic coma, and death. So the prevention are deep penetrating wounds in muscular tissue are dangerous, should be explored. All dead tissue should be completely excised, and if there about the tissue variability should left open the wound. Treatment: general measures are fluid replacement and IV antibiotics, hyperbaric oxygen, mainstay Rompot decompression, and remove dead tissue. So this is all about the fracture and the complications of the fracture. Hope you understand it well. If you have any queries related to this topic, you can ask me in comment section. I will resolve them. This video is powered by digital version of 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. Namaste. Khush rahiye.